Hello, it's Keith from KMA's Korner. How you doing today? As you can see, this will be my first video with my new texture pack, which is basically based on Faithful 32 with a little couple of things added on. But enough of that, there's a whole video on that. Go find it yourself, it's on my channel somewhere. Maybe I'll link it. Probably. But I'm here back at my single player world, and I've done some serious work. Some extra serious work. Alright guys, I have basically finished this. I have yet to test it. But it's been basically filled up. I do need, you know, so a couple of trampling spots, and I didn't have enough seeds, but I will after this harvest. And yeah, nether wart, I didn't have really enough of it. So what I had done is I ended up getting all the sticky pistons, and I just ran a wire up here, just basic wire. So when I hit that button or the lever, it goes up here and goes through there and lifts up, and obviously there's water behind there and it just flows down. Basic thing. You'll never really need to build this thing. This is overkill, but I am working with villagers. You can kind of see it over there right now. So I do need all these supplies. So, but the best part of this thing is not that I hit the button there. It's this thing. These are the things you can get from it. And it's all ready to go. It's basically your normal item sorter. So basically you have the input. Let me get up there. The input. Hearing this water in the background is going to make me want to pee. But the input comes in and it goes through here. And it, each time it goes through, it checks down here to see if it is a place it can go. And to tell whether or not it's a place it can go, you have the do not use me please blocks, the blocks that you name and cover the four spots, and you need 41 of that particular item that you want to go down through here. So when items go through here, it checks each one of these to see if it's in the right, you know, it has something to go to, and if it matches, it will go down there and go into the chests. If it doesn't match, eventually it will come to this end piece here, and that end piece will go to this last chest, and that will be like extra things like poison potatoes that I'm not really going to be collecting and stuff. And it's pretty simple redstone. Really easy. You got the torches there, the comparators coming out of the item marker ones, and you just got the 3-length redstone wire. This is all based on like Impulse SV, so check him out, because he's a guy that kind of made the redstone better and easier. Let's see. Nah, I'm not gonna cover that up. So basically, after it goes through, it'll end up into these chests, and it's pretty easy. Don't think I need to do a tutorial on it. Alright guys, I am back, and obviously you need the redstone to connect this pulse, and here it comes, right down. And my problem, I was a little worried about this happening, so I'm hoping when this comes over it will push everything in the side, seeing that we got the water streams coming from both sides. I should set up a timer so it automatically pushes those things back down after the time it would take for all these items to get into the middle. And obviously there is hoppers underneath here to suck up those items to go into the... Okay. I used to have a step there to climb up here, and I'm glad that it's gone. I forgot I replaced it with this ladder. Short-term memory, first thing to go, again, you see the hoppers there, and it sucks all the items up, and hopefully the items end up down here, whichever one it is going through right now, I don't know. Okay, so the carrots are going in now. So I guess it is working. It's not as efficient or fast as I thought it was going to be sorting through the stuff, but hey, hopefully, I won't be using this all that much. I just needed a couple of really big harvests, which I think that would be. I hope everything gets, yeah. I was gonna say, I hope everything doesn't get despawned. I took out the other farms here, and I am going to build something here. I don't know what yet. Probably these melon farms, because I can't have those type of melon farms. I need those automatic ones that you always see in the center of spawns. So that's what I'm going to do. And I showed you those tracks. What do I have the tracks for? Well, over here, I have the beginnings of a villager breeding system. I am going to go get a couple more villagers. I've already added this one up here. Hello, boy. And I've done lots of trading with him. I've got a stack of frickin' emeralds from him just because I sold him paper. And he sells Death Striders. And he sells another book that's really good. So I may interchange him. But the thing is, with him, you need him 7 blocks away from all this. Normally, I make the farms where you go down 7 blocks and put the doors down there. But instead, I went up 7 blocks high because the best breeder I've ever had was set up like this. So if it works, why not keep using it? So I decided to put the main guy up top instead of down below under the ground, because for some reason whenever I did the underground, it didn't want to work. And that is why I have so many reeds going. So let us see. It's getting a little late. After daylight happens, I'm going to move one of the villagers up. And I decided to conceal this door a little bit better. And I'm going to add probably a piston door right here. Maybe a hopper thing that will push the door closed. So if I needed to open the door, I could push, you know, throw something in the hopper and it will open the door. Because, I don't know. I don't want that to stick out like a sore thumb, and it kind of already is. So I'm going to do some terraforming here and fix that a little bit better. So let's go check out my nether, because that has also changed. Now here we are. Best nether hub ever. And I enclose this. We're at the top of the world. Sitting on top of the world. So I got rid of the spawner the portal down there and moved it up here. And I made a path here to where that village is. And I've already got the villagers on the minecarts and brought them all the way here. And I put that one in. So what I'm going to do is put these two guys in with the carrots. And you're going to join me on that journey. But first, let me go to sleep, because you do not want to be transferring villagers while it's dark out. Because everything in the world will be wanting to go and say hi to your new villagers that you want to keep alive and breed. All right, the sun has decided to come back up. Let's go get ourselves some villagers. Hello. So this is what I do. I just put them in minecarts, which you can suck them up pretty easily just by moving them. And when you get them into the portal, hit on the far edge, get rid of that. Alright, here we go. You're going for a ride, my little buddy. Enjoy. Let me see if I can keep up with you. No! I'll take the shortcut. It's kind of like a race before nighttime, and there's the sun. It's going down, but he'll be inside his little thing before it does. Oh, wow. He made it the whole way. So, guess what? I don't. Aww. And I think a good thing to do now that he's in there is get rid of these tracks so nobody can get in. I just want to make sure there's no way of mobs getting in here. I'm pretty sure we're pretty good right now. So I am going to... Yeah, he's doing his thing. Good man. Oh, I didn't light this up, did I? Shoot. That means let's go let's go sleep real quick because I don't want any mobs spawning in there. I did not put any torches or glowstone up there yet. Then we can get the other guy in there. Here, guy, why don't you come out and try and get that carrot? Yeah, just like that, buddy. Thank you. Why don't you come over here a little bit? Yeah, just right there. Come on. You can do it. Yeah. That's right. Smooth talk the fella. Now, get on the track and go. Go to your home where you want to be. You're going to be with that other farmer. Get in there. Thank you. Let's see. Where did you run off to? I hear you. There you are. Hey, little buddy. Stay right there. No. Dirt, dirt, dirt. Yes. Let's stay right there, buddy. I have a surprise for you. Yes, I do. I hope you like it. Just stay. Yes. Nice little surprise. Let's go for a ride. Come on. Yes. Bye-bye. Good. This guy's gonna get in there. And we're gonna have two villagers in there. Is he making it? I didn't think I had to give him a second push with the... Well, he's still cruising. Wow. I guess having some weight in the minecart really does do something. So let's stop this here. And yes, that's gonna be your friend. Look, he has harvested most of those carrots. Let's make you a little rail so you can go up and over and say hi to your new friend. I don't know what your new friend will be called, but you will like him. And you can make lots of harvests and lots of the baby villagers. And you can live a thug life if you want. So guys, I went back to the base. Made myself a hoe. Gonna get this guy out. I don't know if I ever do damage with him. But I learned an interesting fact. When you trade with a villager, he regains 2 hearts of damage. So if he was damaged 2 hearts and you trade with him, he will get that back. So hopefully these guys go at it. Nothing like a little morning sun to invigorate your morning breakfast. Yeah. So let's go check out how our villagers are doing. I doubt they'd breed right by now because it usually takes 10 minutes for each little baby to be made. So it's going to be like me hanging out here for a while. I'm pretty sure I'm close enough when I'm doing my work over there that, they're like interested in each other already. But you're leaving carrots on the ground! But they're sharing. Aw, how sweet. So this is, they're trying to get in the mood, so obviously everything is working the way it should be. I should get rid of this tree, but you know, I kind of like to, yeah, whatever. Oh, and I forgot to bring over the light again. But basically, when they breed, they'll have a little baby. And he runs around here and he does whatever. And there's a little hole right here for baby to fall into and go bye-bye. There's water stream underneath that hole that brings him out over here. He gets sucked up into this thing. And if the breeder is on, they will go up there and more will be bred. And if you want to turn it off, oh, did I just see hearts? Yes, we're gonna have a baby real soon. Close that. They will stop midway up and they'll die from not being able to breathe. So that's pretty awesome. So in the time that I was breeding with these guys and getting some levels and stuff, not breeding, trading with these guys and getting level, I worked on getting some good 30 enchants on some of my equipment. And let's see, I got this pickaxe efficiency 4, Unbreaking 3, the unbreaking is the important part. I will eventually upgrade this to an efficiency 5. Then that's our good work pick. And there's our fortune pick. So all I need is a silk touch pick. And when I hit 30, I'm going to enchant this. So what I do to cover this in so nothing gets attacked is we do some glowstone work. So let me fill this outside with glass. I hope I brought enough glass over here. And here are the doors for those of you who have forgotten. Sorry guys, I'm imprisoning you. It's not really gonna be that sad, as you'll have lots of friends eventually in here. I mean, I can close that and let them breed a few times, so I have like 20 villagers in here. I may do that, but I just want to see if they're gonna breed and the whole thing works. So we got this outside. I want to show you the best way to do this. We got one there. Oh! Hate the waste of glass. Stick one there. Basically what I do is I put two of these in between each one. Two pieces of glass in between each glowstone. So one, two. And that emanates from the middle one. So in all actuality, this guy right here should be a glowstone. So I'm gonna finish this up. One thing about making rail tracks in a biome like this is that unfortunately you can see exactly where the rails were, so you can see this is the path to the rails because there's no grass here. So if you do something like this, oh little baby, how sweet. So if you do that make sure you bone mail the area again if you are interested in keeping the looks up. So, as you see here, we are completely covered. There's no way these guys can be attacked. And I don't know if I should close that. I think I'm going to. There. Let me see how I can get at that. I want to close that gate. Where? Frickin' tree. Anyway. Just for now. Because the more villagers that you have in there, the better off it's going to be. So I want to grow up to about 20 villagers in here. So I can have lots of babies going, being made. And you don't really want this too close to a place you're gonna hang out with a lot, because this sucker up here, yeah, I'm talking about you, he likes to close doors and stuff. And as you see, I unlocked all his things. There's that book, which I don't know, emerald-wise. I think that's really good. And he's got the glass trade. He's got the flame one, which is good to put on a bow. Fire protection, useless. And his normal name tag things. Oh. So this is basically done. Oops. And all it is now is a waiting period. And I suggest you use carrots, because what do I have going on here? We'll get rid of that. carrots are the best things, I believe, to use in these things. Because wheat has extra inventory space and... I don't know. Potatoes you can cook and eat pretty well. Carrots aren't usually used for much, other than golden carrots. And I don't have a gold farm on here, so I'm not going to be making any golden carrots. And it's not like I'm going to be eating carrots on my own. Plus, I have a whole bunch of stacks over here. I'll revisit my farm. And I did fix the issue with the netherwort. So, off camera, I'm going to replant this and maybe next episode refilter it down. But from that one harvest, I got all this. So, I'm going to have plenty of food to trade with these guys when I get them out. And I think what I'm going to do with this space here, instead of making a home, I'm going to make the villager trading area. And I'm going to move the villagers that are worthy over here, label them so I know exactly what I can trade with from each one. I did record a quick video. If you didn't want to build something like that, that's behind me, for your world, I have a one block farm that, if you have lots of bone meal, it will be much better than wasting your time building something huge and ugly and nasty like that thing. And so I will put up a tutorial, hopefully this week, to explain that. Maybe the day after I release this video, because yeah, I made this huge ass farm. Yeah, it's kind of cool. Yeah, it looks a little weird and so forth, but it has an item sorter, which is kind of cool and stuff, but nobody ever needs to build that thing that's behind me. That was just for fun. I'll show you a great little farm that you can build on your own that takes up about 9 blocks, and you can get a shit ton of stuff. The only catch is that you do need a whole bunch of bone meal. And it's a farm that you've all seen before. But I'll do a tutorial on it so you can build it, and it will take you about 10 minutes to build the stupid thing, even less. And it's much more efficient and much better looking than that thing behind me. But I'm glad that you have stuck around to watch me finish that up and do the villagers over there. And hopefully by the next time I see you guys, I will have a shit ton of villagers in that farm. This is Keith for KMA's Korner. Have a great day. Thumbs up and like this video. My last video, for some reason, not complaining, had 10 times the amount of views as my normal video in a 20-hour span. So I really appreciate that, guys. The Serenity server videos are really, really taking off. And so I hope that some of those views will come over to this particular place. Because right now I'm not planning on staying on Serenity. I just done the holding pattern for another place to accept me as a whitelisted person on their server, and I'm gonna focus on that place if that ever happens. But until then, Serenity will be my place, and I am so psyched about all those views on Serenity. I mean, I uploaded it last night at 5. It's now 5:00 in the morning, and so it's been 12 hours, and my normal video gets 5 to 10 views. This video overnight has had 170. So I don't know what the change is, but I appreciate the change, and I appreciate all those views. So subscribe, thumbs up, get the word out. I would really appreciate that. So have a good day. It's Keith. Goodbye.